If you miss Glenn Beck's Restoring Honor rally, held on the auspicious anniversary of Martin Luther King's March on Washington, don't worry, I clipped you my favorite part. They're playing Amazing Grace, a song originally written by...
John Newton was a slave ship captain in the 1700s. He had eyes, but he could not see the horror that he was engaged in until he was in a storm and he fell to his knees and he said, Lord, help us. Help us, help us, help us. And he did. He was changed in that storm. He went from a captain of a slave ship to a guy who wrote probably the best song for the bagpipes.
Let's set the record straight on that. John Newton did pray for a ship not to be overturned, but after that, he kept on being a slave ship captain for a long time. I mean, the kindest thing that history has to say about John Newton is that he treated his slaves very humanely, which is like praising someone for treating their slaves very humanely. Here's the main point of Beck's speech.
You must choose whether we wallow in our scars. Countries make mistakes. We have made more than our fair share. But it is what you do with those mistakes. We choose to wallow in them, or we learn from the past and ask for redemption.
I agree. People should not be judged based on the worst thing that they've ever done or said. But to acknowledge that our history of racism and inequality still stains our present isn't dwelling on the past. It's perfecting our future. When I say that Glenn Beck and the Tea Party's rise to fame is based on mobilizing racial resentment, what I mean is that white working class folks, just as they're feeling more economically insecure, they're looking around and noticing that there are more blacks and Latinos and gay folks and you name it in their neighborhoods. Of course there are. That's because our nation is getting more diverse. And the truth is that all these groups together are going downhill. Doesn't mean that everybody's in the same position, but roughly speaking, nobody's doing that great. Except for the corporate super rich. They're doing pretty darn well. They're just getting better and better and better off. That's the truth. However, people like Glenn Beck and Sarah Palin want you to draw a different conclusion. They want you to think that white working class people, which, somehow includes the corporate super rich, are faring worse because Latinos and blacks and the gay folks and everybody are getting rights and benefits from the government and from our tax dollars that are somehow making them do better. Yes, somehow blacks and Latinos in the United States are faring better than the corporate super rich. Whether you like it or not, America was built on the extermination of native peoples and with the exploitation of people from Africa. Ever since, we've designed our society so that the wealthy and privileged prosper, while everyone else, whether they're black or immigrants or they're gay or they're women or they're poor white people, start the reach for the American dream a few steps below. The day after his rally, Beck defended the timing of his event by saying the civil rights movement was about people of faith who believe you have an equal right to justice. True that, but you can't pursue equality by denying that inequality exists in the first place. That's, as ugly as,